Today I'm going to show you how to control the fan speed in Mac computer. It can be iMac or the MacBook Pro or any other Mac computer. It can be a laptop, it can be a desktop like iMac. Right now I want to do it in my iMac. So what I do first, we'll go to Google and search it the term with Mac fan control. So I did it my search here, so it comes the search data here. The first search is the Mac fan control 1.1.7 Mac update. So this is the website where you can get most of the Mac related software, and this is the indirect way of getting the Mac software for fan control. Or the best, the other one is a direct website where you can get the software. So in these two instances, first I will go here or maybe here, whichever is you would like to, but I would like to go here and just directly click this and try to. So this Crystal Idea, the company which developed Mac fan control software, it is having for both Windows and Mac. Right now I am going to download for my Mac, and it's just a capacity of 6.3 MB, so just double click it, automatically downloads. And then I saved it on my desktop already, which I downloaded. So here is my Mac and control software. So back to, I will double click this one, and then it unzips the file, and then we can see here the fan control button. So this is where it unzipped. Now I will double click it, and then of course it says Mac fan control is application downloaded from internet. So do you want to, okay, of course we are going to open it. Just open, and then you can see here now the fan already fan control app is showing here. So now I will just single click, and then of course open a show Mac fan control, and then it opens a pop-up window where you can control the fan speeds of various controls. For example, here is optical drive, and here is the hard disk, and here is the CPU. So there are three fans where you can control the heat on these three controls. Of course there is automatic sensor in any Mac computer which automatically senses when it gets heated and then cools it, but at times where you need to get the lower temperature than the automatic temperature to set in, for example the CPU, or for example the GPU here, where the graphic adapter, when it gets heated more than 60-70 degrees, sometimes it may, your computer may freeze, or your monitor may get stop working, your computer will stop working because of high heat, or sometimes the display may get blurred. So to stop all these problems, you need to control the temperature. Those temperatures are in centigrade degrees. So to change the temperatures, you need to control the speed, so that the fan speed, so that the heat is dissipated out under this. So now I'm going to click each one to set my control, what type of control I want to put into this. First I will click the ODD, that is optical disk. And here is, you can see the options, automatic, constant RPM, or sensor based. So I will select as sensor based. Of course you can also do the constant. You can set what the RPM you want, and of course I will go sensor based. And to this, what sensor you want to select to control the temperature. For example, the sensor from ODD, you don't need to select ODD sensor only, but you can select any of these sensors where to control the temperature. So in my case, I just did the GPU diode, where the highest temperature it generally used to record. So where the moment it rises, you can, or of course when you are using this optical disk, then only this temperature control is needed. Mostly, otherwise it's okay. As long as it is not being used, it may not get much heat. So, but of course, in this case, I will just try to set some control here, GPU heat sink, and the lowest. What is the lowest temperature you want? You can just type it, whatever the temperature you want. In my case, I just put it 32 degrees, and the maximum temperature it is 45. So it never allowed to go more than 45 degrees, and then the moment it reaches 32 degrees, it starts, the fan speed starts and goes the level set what it was set. So that is how we can do. So here in this case, we've done, and of course here the most important is to HDD, that is hard disk, and then CPU. So these two, most of the times I used to select the GPU, because the reason is the GPU, the highest temperature it wants. So it has to be controlled, and your CPU, the heat has to be dissipated out by giving the lower value so that your computer works perfectly all right. So I did all the selection. So you can select any of these to your desired values, but mind that you are responsible for your actions, whatever you do in your computer. So careful when you are setting all these things. So preferences, all these things you can do. Once you set, just leave it automatically. It keep controlling the temperature. So you can see the fan speed is changing based on the temperatures what I set in that one. So that's it. So as I said, that this is one of the best app and it is free. So as I said, that is one of the good app I ever come across for Mac, and of course there is a Windows version as well. So if you like my video, please leave your comments. You can subscribe to my channel, and of course you can also share with your friends, family, so that they will also get benefit from this video. Thanks for watching once again. Goodbye.